Welcome to the quantum crypto session. So our first talk will be by Tamayoke, and he'll tell us about one-way-ness in quantum cryptography.
Thank you for the introduction. So this is a joint work with Takashi Yamakawa. If you attended my yesterday's talk, the summary of the first part was this one. So one-way function, minimum assumption in classical cryptography. Okay? And again, so one-way function is the following one. So this is an efficiently computable function, and security is defined in the following one. So challenger choose random bit string X and send f of X to the adversary. So if you require quantum security, this adversary is quantum polynomial time. And if you require classical security, this adversary should be PPT, probabilistic polynomial time. An adversary must return some X prime, some bit string, that should be preimage of this f of X. And security means the probability that this X prime is in the preimage set is negligibly small. This is a one-wayness. And this is a definition of one-way function. And so yesterday also I explained this classical crypto zoo. So we have three worlds, Pechiland, where no one-way function exists, which means no classical crypto is possible, and mini crypt, where one-way function exists. And if one-way function exists, many other primitives exist, like pseudo-random generators, commitments, zero knowledge, secret key encryption, and digital signatures, and so on. So they are equivalent to one-way functions. So this means that if one-way function exists, you can construct these primitives from one-way functions. Or if these primitives exist, one-way function exists. So they are equivalent. And also we have another world, cryptomania, where more advanced functionalities are possible, like PKE, public key encryption, key exchange, multi-party computation, and so on. And there is a barrier between these two worlds. So we believe that we will not be able to construct these primitives, cryptomania primitives, from one-way functions in a black box way. On the other hand, these primitives, cryptomania primitives, imply one-way functions. And this means if one-way function do not exist, all of them do not exist. Because these mini crypto primitives are equivalent to one-way function. So if one-way function do not exist, they don't exist. And because these cryptomania primitives imply one-way functions, so if one-way function do not exist, then these cryptomania primitives do not exist as well. So in this way, one-way function are the minimum assumption in classical cryptography. Okay, and the summary of the second part of my yesterday talk is this one, but on the other hand, in quantum case, situation is very different. So in quantum case, even if one-way function do not exist, still cryptography is possible. Actually, so we have another new world in between Pechiland and Minicrypt. And in this world, we have new primitives like EFI pairs, PRXG, and OneWayXG. And they seem to be weaker than one-way functions because, for example, Kretschmann showed that these primitives could exist even if one-way functions do not exist. But on the other hand, they imply many nice applications like commitment, SKE, digital signature, and so on, and even multi-party computation. So in this way, in quantum case, even if one-way function do not exist, still we have many applications. And the question is, how these new micro crypto primitives are related with each other. And the goal of this talk is clarify several relations among these micro crypto primitives. And this is a summary of result. So this is a summary of all known result. And this rate allows results in this talk. So first I explain this result. Equivalence between one-way puzzle and weak, sorry, one-way state generator and weak one-way state generator. So one-way state generator is a quantum analog of one-way function, which is a quantum polynomial time algorithm. So on input, classical key k, that output a quantum state, phi k. And security is a quantum analog of one-wayness. So challenger choose key k and sends t copies of phi k to the adversary, QPT adversary. And this QPT adversary must output some bit string k star such that this is accepted by the verification algorithm by the challenger. And security, one-wayness, means that the probability that this k prime is accepted is negligibly small. This is just a quantum version of one-wayness. And one result is a weak one-way SG is equivalent to one-way SG. So this is again the definition of one-way SG. So for any quantum polynomial time adversary A and for any polynomial T, the probability that adversary wins is negligibly small. So this is a definition of one-way SG. And weak one-way SG is just a quantum analog of weak one-way function. So in classical case, we have one-way function and weak one-way function, and they are known to be equivalent. And in quantum case, we can define weak version of one-way state generator, which is this one. So there exists some polynomial P such that for any QPT adversary and for any polynomial T, the probability that A wins is upper bounded by 1 minus 1 over P. And our result is they are equivalent. So in classical case, they are equivalent. And we show that also in quantum case, they are equivalent. And this equivalence is useful to show several results in this paper. And second result is a construction of one-way state generator from pure private quantum money. So private quantum money is the following. Private key quantum money is the following one. So we have a mint algorithm that output quantum money state on input key k. And security is defined in the following way. So challenger first choose key k and sends t copies of money state to the QPT adversary. The QPT adversary must return some quantum state rho, which consists of many registers. And challenger verify each register one by one and counts the number of acceptance. And if this number is larger than t, this means this adversary can forge money. So because adversary receives t copies of money state, but now the adversary can output more than t copy of quantum money. So this means this money is copied. And security means the probability of such event is negligibly small. This is the definition of quantum money. And we show that pure money, so private key quantum money with pure banknote imply one-way state generator. And the construction is very simple. So just the output of one-way SG is taken as the banknote state. And security is also easy. So if this one-way state generator, one-way state is invertible, intuitively you can get a key. And by using this key, you can copy. Okay. And so the remaining open problem is the other direction. So open question is whether we can construct private key quantum money from one-way state generator. And this is non-trivial because even if you can clone, still there is no guarantee that you can find the key. Okay, so now I explain the second. Sorry, third result, equivalence between one waste generator and digital signature. So quantum digital signature is the following one. So sender first runs the key generation, secret key generation algorithm to output classical secret key. This is signing key. And then the sender runs a public key generation algorithm that output quantum public key. And the reason why we have these two algorithms for SK and PK is because now this PK is a quantum state. And if we want to get many copies of PK, we need this separated key generation algorithms. Because in general, this PK cannot be cloned. And T copies of this public key, quantum public key, is sent to the adversary. And adversary can query signing oracle many times, few times. And after querying this signing oracle, adversary output some message M star and also some bit string sigma star. And security means this pair is not accepted as a valid pair of message and signature, except for negligibly small probability. And also this M star shouldn't be queried before. And this is a quantum digital signature. And so our result is this is equivalent to one waste generator. And first I explain simple version, namely one time secure digital signature from one way SG. And to explain that, I explain the classical version. Of construction of one-time secure digital signature from one-way function. And this is known as Lamport signature, some textbook, very standard construction. So F is one-way function, and secret key is some randomly chosen K0 and K1. And the public key is F of K0 and F of K1. And signing algorithm is just output K0 or K1. So if the message is zero, corresponding signature is K0. And if message is one, corresponding signature is K1. And the verification is just evaluating one-way function. So given signature, receiver evaluate this F of sigma and check whether this is equivalent to public key or not. This is a classical construction of one-time secure digital signature from one-way function. And now just we quantize this one. So instead of F of K0 and K1, now this is phi K0 and phi K1. That are output of one-way state generators. And verification is just we run the verification algorithm of one-way state generator. And security is come from the one-wayness of this one-way state generator. So the adversary can access this public key, many copies of this quantum public key. But one-wayness means that from this public quantum key, adversary cannot run K0 and K1. That's why adversary cannot forge the signature. And actually, we show that one-way generator is equivalent to Q-time quantum digital signature with a bounded poly-Q. And the open question is whether we can construct unbounded poly-time secure quantum digital signature. And actually, in classical case, this is possible. So in classical case, if you just see some standard textbook of classical cryptography, many times secure digital signature is constructed from one-way function. But in quantum case, we don't know how to do that. And recently, there is one negative result to this open question. So Corradangelo and Mutoreja show that there is some oracle. Actually, this is Kretschmer oracle, so some Haarlander unitary, and also p-space oracle, relative to which many times secure digital signature do not exist, but PRU exists. So this means maybe we will not be able to construct many times secure digital signature from PRU. But this is just some prohibit some specific type of digital signature. So in particular, this signature is quantum bit string. But this could be quantum state, for example. And if this is quantum state, this novel result doesn't work. So still, it could be possible to construct some type of many times secure contract digital signature from, for example, PRU. Okay, and so now I explain this result, construction of a message generator from one-time SKE. And also I explain this one. And one-time secure SKE is the following one. So quantum cipher text one-time SKE is the following. So sender first runs the key generation algorithm that output classical secret key, and also sender choose bit B, and sender encrypt this bit B by using secret key. And sender output some quantum cipher text, and many copies of this quantum cipher text is sent to the QPT adversary. The QPT adversary must output B prime that should be equal to B. And security means the probability that B prime is equal to B is small. Okay. And also I define EFI pairs, which is two efficiently generatable quantum states that are statistically far, but computationally indistinguishable. So their trace distance is large. So in principle, you can distinguish these two states, but computationally you cannot. And the first result is one-time SKE imply one-way state generator. And the construction is the following one. So this is the output of one-way state generator, which consists of some bit string X and also ciphertext corresponding to X. And very intuitively, if given this state, if you can find K, then you can decrypt this ciphertext. And that's why this SKE is broken. And also construction of EFI pairs from one-time SKE is given in the following way. So row zero is this state and row one is this state. So row zero is a tensor product of some ciphertext, quantum ciphertext, for some message XZ. So this X and Z are some bit strings. And so this classical bit strings are encrypted. And this is a maximally entangled state. And only this Pauli one-time pad is applied on half of this Bell state. Sorry, maximally entangled state. And on the other hand, this row one is very similar to this one, but the difference is here, instead of a maximally entangled state, now you have this all zero state and a maximally mixed state. So I forgot this normalization, but this is a maximally mixed state. And so there is a result that says that if key length is shorter than the message length, then row zero and row one are statistically far. So they are statistically far. And also you can easily understand that they are computationally indistinguishable because of the definition of this SKE. So because this XZ are encrypted, and if you apply Pauli one-time pad, they are indistinguishable. So in this way, we get EFI pairs statistically far and computationally indistinguishable. Okay, so in this way, we show this result. And this is the end of my talk. Thank you very much.
So when you define quantum digital signatures, the public key assumes to be a quantum state as well, right? What if we require the public key to be classical? And I mean, signatures can be quantum as well. Do we know the equivalence? Does that still hold?
Yeah, so that's a good question. So ideally this PK should be classical instead of a quantum state. And at this case, here security means given some classical data, adversary must output some classical data, now quantum data.
Right.
So this should be reduced to some quantum input, classical output primitive, quantum output primitive. So For example, one-way puzzle is given classical data. You have to output classical data. So maybe this is slightly different. Maybe if you define some primitive such that given classical data, you cannot output quantum data. Maybe you can show some relation between this and that one.
Okay. So it's not immediately clear from one-way state and the standard version of one-way state generators.
Yeah, it's not immediately clear.
Okay. Okay. Thanks. All right. Are there other questions?
So you mentioned that, you know, like this multi-time digital signature, like the negative result, like, you know, still not that negative. And like, do you have some scheme in mind, like, or, you know, like, I mean, through which one can potentially.
Sorry, what?
Oh, so the one-way state generator, or maybe a mistake, okay. That already implies.
You mean this one?
Yeah.
And what's your question?
No, I think you had it there. I missed it. Okay.
Okay.
More questions? Well, maybe I'll ask one more. Can you explain a little bit the challenges for constructing multi-time signatures?
Yeah, okay. So in classical case, first you so here from one-way function, you can get one-time secure digital signature. And from so in classical case, from that you get a multi-time secure digital signature. And standard technique in textbook is you sign public key. But here you cannot you don't know how to assign public key because this is a quantum state. And in general, it is known that you cannot assign quantum state. This is one issue here.
Okay, thanks. Well, if we don't have further questions, let's thank the speaker again.